We're here with the governor, and thank you for spending time. Let me ask you the first question about, you talked last night about Executive Order 28. Tell us about that in a nutshell.
Yeah, I've been so concerned because we saw 9 fentanyl overdoses in one school in Loudoun County, and parents hadn't been notified. And this is really dangerous for kids because there are illegal drugs that have been laced with fentanyl being passed around and parents weren't being told. So my executive order requires school systems to notify parents within 24 hours of a school-related drug overdose so parents can be informed and talk to their kids about it. I will not have a parent not informed when we know that bad stuff's going on in schools.
Parents' involvement, big part of your campaign running for governor. What are you doing about the 3,400 wrongly removed from the voting polls, and what can be done to get them to be able to vote on Tuesday?
Well, they've all been restored. And in fact, we worked very quickly. When this issue first was brought to my attention, I asked everyone to go back and recheck and double check to make sure, because everyone who has a legal right to vote should be allowed to vote. And of course, there were nearly 3,400 folks that had been mistakenly classified as having committed a subsequent felony to their original felony, and they were mistakenly removed. We immediately worked to get them all restored, and they are all now back on the voter rolls and ready to vote.
Can they vote on Tuesday?
Absolutely, they can.
Big election issue, abortion, and the blue firewall Democrats are putting up to block further restrictions. What are you doing about that blue firewall dealing with abortion?
Well, first, we're being very clear about our position. There should be no questions. Our position is to, in fact, provide a bill that will protect life at 15 weeks when a baby can feel pain, with full exceptions for rape and incest, and when a mother's life is at risk. What the other side is saying is wrong. They keep saying we're going to ban abortion with no exceptions, and they're just not telling truth. They want to extend abortion all the way up through and including birth. They've said it over and over again. That was a bill that missed by one vote 3 years ago. And now we're just being clear. They want no exceptions. We have been clear with reasonable exceptions. Nearly 70% of Virginians support a position to protect life at 15 weeks when a baby can feel pain, with full exceptions for rape and incest and when the mother's life is at risk. And this is a choice for voters to make. I just want to be really clear. What they're saying about many of our candidates, that they're going to try to ban abortion, is not true. This is not a ban. It's a reasonable limit that I think Virginians should be able to come around.
Now, you heard the slogan is keep the House, flip the Senate. If you are able to do that, it would be a really big deal. My question is, sir, if you do that, what does that say about your leadership on a national level that you were able to do that?
Yeah. Well, I think it says that Virginians have come together around common sense policies that work. And Virginia was near the bottom of job growth, and now we're near the top of job growth. We've reduced taxes by $5 billion, and those checks are out in the mail this week. We backed the blue. We've focused on education, and it's working. It's working. And I think that's what it says, is that common sense policies do work, and Virginians support them.
If that happens, that you all are able to flip the Senate and keep the House, does that mean on a national level that you become a formidable force because you were able to do this on your watch, and that you would be able to run for a national office, say, in 2024?
Well, I'm so focused on Virginia. I'm going to do the work for Virginia.
But and you know, I look, they're talking about that.
And it's humbling. You know, I grew up right down here, and when I was 15, I was taking out trash and washing dishes down at the beach, and to have my name tossed around in this is really exciting. But we're focused on Virginia. We are going to hold our House. We're working to flip the Senate. We're working to make sure that Virginia is the best place to live, work, raise a family, and I look forward to delivering for Virginians.
Let me try one more time. You do acknowledge that if you are able to flip the Senate and keep the House, that that is a real big political deal, and that that would put you in a new limelight for the national stage in the next year, 2024.
You know, Andy,
do you admit that?
And Andy, this is not the first time this question's been asked. You're doing a really good job asking it over and over again.
But no one's asked it that way.
And I will repeat what I've said, which is I am so excited that the nation is watching what's happening in Virginia, because it's working. And I just ask for folks to elect delegates and senators who will work with me and don't block all the good things that we have going. They can trust us. We're going to deliver for them. And I promise that.
Thank you very much. And this is Andy. Over here is Andy Pittman. He's out here campaigning for Andy Pittman. We're out of time. Taki here from Azalea Inn. Good to see you, Taki. Absolutely. And thank you so much
thank
for giving
you.
Us this
Thank
you.
And
time.
Andy Pittman would make a great delegate for Norfolk. So elected.
Thank you very much. Hey, guys, that's the latest with Governor Glenn Youngkin. I did my best, and they are really looking to...
Hold the House, flip the Senate.
Tuesday, we'll see what happens. There has never been more money spent in General Assembly elections in the history of our Commonwealth. I think over $400 million came in the month of October alone. Unbelievable. Wow. That's the latest, guys, from Norfolk. Andy Feist, guys,
go
back
vote,
to you.
Go vote, go vote.
Did my best.
Andy, you're tough. Bless you.
Thank you. That's great. Thanks.